beating heart of the nation.
Londinium to the Romans, Ludenwick to the Saxons, Londonburg to Alfred the Great. But to all generations since, London. Our London of today.
London has known suffering.
Horror has come to London.
But London always rises again.
East, please.
London is a monument to the hard times, to the good.
Celebration of what we have been and what we are today. London. Our heart and our sinews and our voice.
Up and down the city road, in and out of the Eagle. That's the way the money goes, as fuck goes the weasel.
Poetry and prose, people and places. London now throws open its doors on a new theatre of dreams.
This city now doth like a garment wear the beauty of the morning, silent, bare.
A city in waiting, a city on the move. Humans on the move, the fascination with making the next step faster, higher, stronger, and putting the fastest and the strongest to the test. This is London of the Olympic Games. And since this is our heart, and our voice. London must feel and speak of romance, of love.
That when you turned and smiled at me, a nightingale
fell. London is ready. So take a deep breath.
Absolutely faultless.
Ne'er so I never felt a calm so deep. The river glideth at his own sweet will.
He has blown them all away!
Dear God, the very houses seem asleep, and all that mighty heart is lying still.
But not for long. For London is about to cry out with heart and soul. Let the games commence.
It's been quite a journey. 7 years we've waited, and now on the evening of July the 27th, 2012, this relatively small plot of land in East London will take its place at the centre of the sporting world. Over the next few hours, the Olympic flame will meander its way to its resting place, where it will glow for the next 17 days. Good evening and welcome to London 2012. For intensity and excellence, nothing compares with the modern Olympic Games. The greatest show on earth is about to